There are three fundamental exercises and two basic postures that swallow therapists use to help a patient overcome swallowing difficulties as a part of a comprehensive treatment plan. The swallowing exercises are performed in order to strengthen the swallowing muscles to more effectively swallow without problems. Just like any other muscle in the body, targeted exercise will make a muscle stronger and more efficient. Positioning maneuvers are to help with swallowing, but it's more geared towards helping to close off the airway, thereby minimizing risk of aspiration. Okay, to begin, let's go over the exercises first. The first technique is the Masako Maneuver, which improves the function of the back of the throat during swallowing. For this exercise, the tongue is stuck out and placed between the teeth. Then you swallow while keeping your tongue held between the teeth the entire time. Perform 10 times, 3 times a day. The second exercise is the Mendelsohn Maneuver, which is a bit more difficult. When you swallow normally, the Adam's apple or your larynx moves upwards. You can feel this movement by feeling for the notch at the top part of your voice box and then swallowing. So when food or liquids go down with a swallow, the voice box moves upwards and then back down as a swallow is completed. With the Mendelsohn Maneuver, you squeeze the throat muscles as tightly together as possible the moment the voice box raises to its highest level during a swallow. The tongue is pressed tightly against the roof of the mouth. Hold this position for 3 to 5 seconds before relaxing. So you swallow and squeeze the throat, and then you hold it before you let it go. When holding the throat in this tightly squeezed position, you're holding your breath, which is what naturally occurs during a swallow. This exercise just accentuates and strengthens that natural breath holding during a swallow. Perform 5 to 10 Mendelsohn maneuvers 3 times a day. The third strengthening exercise is to help with the swallow timing, called a supraglottic swallow. There are 3 steps. First, you're gonna hold your breath, swallow, and then finally, step 3, you're gonna cough after the swallow is completed. Now let's talk about the 2 positioning maneuvers to help with swallow. Remember, these maneuvers help to close the airway to prevent aspiration of food or liquids. With both positions, remember to always sit upright when you eat. It's very important to make sure that the person with the swallowing disorder is sitting up at 90 degrees every single time they swallow anything. It's easier to do this in a chair, but if they happen to be in bed, make sure to still sit up in the bed at 90 degrees or as far as they can go. Okay, the first and most common position technique is called a chin tuck. Right before initiating a swallow, tuck the chin down to the chest, and once the head is down, swallow hard and fast, keeping the head all the way down the entire time. Once the swallow has been completed, then bring the head back up. By bringing the chin down to the chest, it just helps to protect the airway as it opens the throat up in a way that makes it easier to swallow without aspiration. For some patients, this is the only way they're able to swallow safely. Second positioning maneuver helps mostly with people who've had a stroke that affects one side of their throat and vocal cords. For example, if someone had a stroke on the left side of the body, it's common to also have issues with the left side of the throat and voice box. In this situation, swallowing should occur with the head turned towards the affected side or the side that's not working. Then, swallowing in this position, food and liquids preferentially goes down the opposite good side as the head turn essentially narrows closed the bad side of the throat. Beyond these basic swallowing strategies to help improve swallow, be sure to always use small sips or bites at a time. Perform 1 or more dry swallows after each bite or sip. After taking a bite of solid foods, chase it down with a sip of liquids. With liquids, hold it in the mouth for 2 to 3 seconds before attempting to swallow. Be sure to work with a qualified speech-language pathologist to further optimize and improve any persistent problems. Good luck!